From the Library of Congress in Washington, D.C.
Hello, everyone. My name is Betsy Peterson, and I'm the director of the American Folklife Center here at the Library of Congress, and I want to welcome you on behalf of all of our staff, welcome you here today for the first concert of the Homegrown Concert Series for 2013 here in the Coolidge Auditorium. And just a word about the series. The series is an opportunity for us to present to folks in D.C. and folks who are visiting D.C., some of the best traditional music and dance from around the United States. To produce the series, we work with folklorists and state folk arts coordinators from all over the country who help us identify artists to bring here and present to you today. So when we do this, we also work with other organizations. We work with the Millennium Stage at the Kennedy Center. And actually, I think our artists here today will be performing there later on. And in the case of this concert, we are also working with the Smithsonian Folklife Festival, which will be beginning tomorrow out on the Mall. So if you all are either live here or visiting, please go down and you'll be able to hear lots of wonderful music and meet a lot of wonderful people. So today, we have a very special treat, a very special concert of the Onsky Yiddish Heritage Ensemble, which features renowned Yiddish folk singers Michael Alpert and Ethel Rehm, cymbalist Pete Ruszewski, and violinist Jake Schulman-Mint. The group is a special group celebrating the 100th anniversary of the historic Onsky expedition. The expedition is named for its leader, the Yiddish writer, folklorist Semyon Onsky, best known as author of the Dybbuk. And the Onsky expedition of 1911 and 1914 systematically documented Jewish folk culture of dozens of communities in Ukraine. The Onsky materials stand alone as an unparalleled record of a pre-industrial Jewish society. And all of the field work was carried out in the Yiddish language. Inspired by Onsky's work and affiliated with the New York-based Center for Traditional Music and Dance, the Onsky Yiddish Heritage Ensemble, is a supergroup, if you will, of four leading performers and researchers all in their own right of Yiddish folk songs and exciting klezmer instrumentals collected through field and archival research. So without further ado, I want to turn it over to them, but I first want to actually ask you, if you haven't turned off your cell phone, to do so now. We also do record these concerts, and you will be able to hear them on our website, on the American Folklife Center website, shortly. So without further ado, the Onsky Musical Heritage Ensemble.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you very much for coming out to hear some post-pre-industrial music from the Yiddish or East European Jewish tradition. We are from my right to my left. Jake Shulman-Ment on violin, Pete Ryszewski on cymbal, which is this wonderful Yiddish version of the hammered dulcimer, and Ethel Rahim, towering figure in folk song and folklore for many years. I'm Michael Alpert, and we're presenting today music and other performance traditions, instrumental music, song, and something else that come out of, once again, out of the traditions of Jewish Eastern Europe. This is much of it, just basically all of it, is music that comes from a time from either the time or the genres that were before that preceded the Jewish American experience, or were common at the beginning of that time, the sort of the late in 19th and early 20th centuries, although have continued into the present day too. This is not just a revival music, and we'll hear something about it, this tradition's continuity as we go on too. We're gonna continue now with a song called In Draußen geht der Regen, Outside It's Raining. It's a love song. Its message is basically, the message was basically, trust me. And you said I should trust you, actually. And
we know what that means.
It's not a sad, in the great spectrum of the Yiddish tradition, it's and a lot of other traditions of love songs, this is not a sad song at all. It's mainly unresolved. So, goodbye.
In Drüssen geht der Regen, am linken Regen, die Steindalache sind ein schönes Nuss. Die Steindalache sind ein schönes Nuss. Oi, Dios, mir zigesucht, hat die Westmacht nehmen, ich soll kein Mund nicht und kein Verdruss. Tarjam, tarjam, tarjam,
Mir zeh lein di tabala tsvei,
So that one ended really nice as two doves. This one ends not so nice, and it's a young woman who takes a walk into the forest with her sweetheart, and weather it's cold, and so she gives him her scarf, and then all of a sudden they encounter some robbers, and she says, "Oh no, you can kill me, not him." And then they come back, and he takes another. And she says, as soon as she hears the plates breaking, which is the celebration of the wedding, she will do herself in. Beautiful song, learned from Itta Taub. How does it go? Oy vey mamen, ich spiel a liebe, in fin der liebe tit mir vey mein Herz, in fin der liebe tit mir vey mein Herz, oy effend menschen, na ere heugen, bet ihr sehn, zoi wie keule schwarz, oh, jeffend Menschen, eure Heugen, wird ihr sehen, so wie Keule schwarz. Euch spazieren bin ich mit meinen Geliebten gegangen, die Pagode ist gewehen, schrecklich kalt, die Pagode ist gewehen, schrecklich kalt. Oi, ui, sketun, hab ich mein Seiden, tichale, in sie gebinden, ihm his Holz. Oi, ui, sketun, hab ich mein Seiden, tichale, in sie gebinden, hab ich sein Holz. Oi, spazieren bin ich mit meinen Geliebten gegangen, vergangen sind mir in a tiefen Wald, vergangen sind mir in a tiefen Wald. Oi hat mir niem gewollt geheulen, in hintergestellt hab ich mein Holz. Oi hat mir niem gewollt geheulen, in hintergestellt hab ich mein Holz. Oh, er is a weg, a husen wären, in Stern will ich hinter ein Fenster bei ihr, in Stern will ich hinter ein Fenster bei ihr. Oh, wie nur mein verdorrten Teller brebrechen, manzen Mommen, will ich sehe und hin. Oi, wie Normen, wir dorten Teller brebrechen. Oi, ja, manzen Mommen, will ich sehe und hin. Okay, a satirical song. What does the Rebbe want? Latkes mit Schmaltz, with goose fat. So he and his wife will be well in the throat. What else would the Rebbe want? To be pleased, of course. How about a bowl of soup, chicken soup, of course. So he and his wife will be well in boich, in the stomach. And the third is a plate of fish, so he and his wife will be well in the feet. It rhymes in Yiddish.
In this dialect, it rhymes so well that it's exactly the same word.
Because you're going to come in, let's have a note. Gabe, was will der Rebbe will me soll in der Langen, was latkes mit Schmaus, als der Rebbe mit der Rebbezen soll seine gesund in der Haus. Liko vidionte bim bam bam bam, liko vid Shabbos bim bam bam bam. Liko vidionte bim bam bam bam, liko vid Shabbos bim bam. Gaber, was will der Rebbe? Der Rebbe will, soll in der Langen. Wo's a Teller mit Joi?
Normally my voice is loud enough to carry, but we're being documented today. So, but thanks so much to the Library of Congress. It's really a thrill for us to be here and be part of all the wonderful, amazing festivities at the Smithsonian this week. We'll be at the Millennium Stage at the Kennedy Center tonight, and it's really a thrill. So I'm Pete Reshevsky. Back home, we're all from New York City, and we have this organization called Center for Traditional Music and Dance. We're in our 45th year, which we can't believe. So, and as Betsy mentioned, talked a little bit about it. It's an organization we work to preserve, present, nurture the continuity of performing arts of immigrant communities in the city. And a person who's been there for just about all those 45 years is our co-founder and artistic director, Ethel Rame, who some of you might actually know from one of her previous careers, either at Sing Out magazine, with the Lomax, Alan Lomax, or as the leader of the Penny Whistlers, which was a really important group in the folk revival.
Long time ago.
So thanks, Ethel. And of course, Michael Alpert, many of you know, really, who's been for 40 years almost a really pioneering, almost 40 years, Michael, a pioneering figure in this renaissance and revitalization of Yiddish culture around the world. And we have the best darn klezmer musician under age 30. Jake, you're still under age 30 for the next few weeks. Jake Shulman-Ment, right there. So it's a real treat for us. I want to just say one thing. It's wonderful also to be here at the library because back at the center, we have this wonderful archive that for over 45, 50 years, Ethel her co-founder Martin Koenig, and the staff have been collecting incredible music in New York City, documenting amazing traditional performing arts across immigrant communities. And the importance of archives is in the folklore field is so important, not just for preserving something that exists in the past, but ideally having something that contemporary artists can use to inform contemporary practice of artistic traditions and ensure that they continue to grow and thrive and things like that. And that's something we really want to do. And a prime example of that happened right here at the library. I don't know if it was about a year ago, the Yiddish Radio Conference, about a year ago, where our good friend Henry Sapoznik's collection of old Yiddish radio programs was donated to the library. And as celebration for that, they had a symposium. And one of the staff members here at the library, Matthew Barton, really kind of surprised all of us in the klezmer world because he found a track by Joseph Moskowitz. Now, some of you might not know that name, probably most of you, but some of you, anybody here from New York, grew up in New York City, especially around the 40s, 50s, did you ever hear a restaurant called Moskowitz and Lupowitz's? I see a lot of nodding heads. This was a big time Lower East Side establishment. It was a restaurant, it was frequented. You'd see the mayor there, you'd see movie stars, Second Avenue theater stars, and folks like that. And one of the proprietors was this guy named Joseph Moskowitz, who was a world-class cymbalum player. So the instrument I'm playing, in Hungarian it's cymbalum, in Yiddish we call it the cymbal. It's the traditional hammer dulcimer of the Yiddish world and across Eastern Europe, really. But this man Moskowitz was very interesting. So Matthew came and played this fragment of a radio program he found from 1936 on Edwin's nationally broadcast show. Edwin was a comedian, and of Moskowitz performing. It's a real treasure because we have so little recorded examples of what traditional Jewish cymbal playing sounded like. Oh, there's really only a few tracks of Moskowitz, and you know some other traditional tracks of from Europe and America of cymbal and violin. So that's really a gem. So I'm going to actually present this piece. Interestingly, Joseph Moskowitz was born in 1879 in Galatz, which is just south of Bessarabia, now the Republic of Moldova. It's kind of where the Danube flows out to the Danube Delta into the Black Sea. That's where this city of Galatz is. So this is where Joseph Moskowitz came from. He immigrated to this country in, I think, the second decade of the 20th century. And he opened up he was a restaurant. He realized he couldn't make it alone as a musician, so he became a restaurateur, opened up a bunch of restaurants on the Lower East Side. But he finished his career right here in Washington, D.C., in a place called Michel's Restaurant. Anybody remember Michel's? It was on Vermont off of DuPont Circle? Okay. I'm glad we have a lot of foodies in the audience tonight. That really helps the shtick. And interestingly enough, I've recently learned from Scott Rosenthal. Scott, I don't know if Scott's here. He's a descendant of Moskowitz's wife. One of Moskowitz's biggest fans, I kid you not, was when he would play at Michel's, a young congressman from California would come back in the early 50s, and he would always come when Moskowitz was playing. And he would kind of sit by himself and, you know, pay his respects and, you know, spend a nice time. Well, it turned out it was Richard Nixon. He was a big Joseph Moskowitz fan. So it's an amazing piece of knowledge we've learned from this recent discovery of this tape. So I'm going to perform this tune that Matthew performed, but Matthew played as part of this 1936 program. It's Joseph Moskowitz, an original tune called Oriental Motif.
Ein, zwei, ein, zwei, drei. Thank you.
A lot of the early Yiddish song tradition was unaccompanied, and of course lullabies for sure. And the lullabies are so varied. So we've put together three, and one is about a father who's going to go and get a bird for his child and a flower for his child. And the second one is curious, and it's about Dreyfusol. It's about the Dreyfus case, and she says, this is a song I heard when I was growing up in my crib, and she says, don't be afraid, don't worry. Dreyfus was killed because he was a Jew, but don't be afraid just because you're a Jew. It's a it's a very sweet, I learned it from Lifshe, Sheikh de Widman, a fantastic reservoir of songs, probably well over 300 songs in her repertoire. And this is a song she actually learned from a hurdy-gurdy player, so it's really nice and fast, which is unusual for a lullaby. And the third lullaby is one, again, from the repertoire of Itta Taub, a wonderful singer who lived in New York and who used to come to the Zingereis at the Gottesman household. Bela's daughter, I mean, Lifsch's daughter is Bela Gottesman, Schechte Gottesman, and they would have Zingereis. People would come over, they'd have some food, and then they'd sit around and sing unaccompanied, and those are really, I didn't attend much of those, but I attended camps where that happened, and I would sneak out to hear the adult camp, and they would wait around before they went to dinner, and they would just sit and sing, and it was just so beautiful. So the first one, B flat, maybe? B. Aida lulu kleininke, aida lulinku. Aida lulu sheininke, aida lulinku. Der Tate is in Waldeweg, in Waldeweg, mein Kind. A feigel wird bringen dir, a feigele, mein Kind. Aida lulu. Kleininke, Aida Lulinku, Aida Lulu Sheininke, Aida Lulinku. Der Tate is in Feldaweg, in Feldaweg, mein Kind. A blimel wetter brengen dir, a blimel le man kind. Aida lulu kleininke, aida lulinku, aida lulu sheininke, aida. Aida lululu, wo's mein Mame pfleg mir singen bei mein Wiegerle. Ai, lalula, die ganze Welt singt doch das Liederle. Hab kein Meure, Dreyfus um mein Kind, vergess nicht, dass sie bist der Idole. Was in Frankreich hat dort passiert, weiß da jeder ganz gut. Man hat verurteilt Kapitän Dreyfus, nur der Fahrer, weil er ist ein Jid. Ai, lalula, die ganze Welt singt auf das Liederle. Hat kein Meure, Dreyfus um mein Kind, vergesst nicht, dass du bist ein Idole. Wenn ich wollt gehört dem Käses äußeres mit seinen ganzen Liebe, wollt es nicht geben bei mir nicht, wie die bist bei mir nicht, mein Kind, mein Kreuz. Wenn ich der Seide, weiß ich doch mir aus, als die ganze Welt ist mein. Schluf, mein Kind, schluf, mein Kind, so's nur leben. Sein Gesind. Ailulu. Ailulu. Wenn ich will amol darf auf jener Welt gehen, wollen teuren Finnen gneden, fahr mir offen stehen, weil die mein Kind wird sein Afrimer in Agiter, wird mir suchen auf jener Welt, los da rein dem Zodiks Mieter. Kind, schluf, mein Kind, sollst nur leben in sein Gesind.
Keep clapping. Everyone, every time you see someone putting on an accordion, you can.
takes a while.
Yeah. I mean, you didn't have to clap for that, just kind of to fill the space. Right? Careful, he's got an accordion.
Thank you. dazu fin kleinser Walle, direkt bis kein Grude. Fort auf Schabe sich zum Reppen, Repp zu dir. Heut zu dir, Kisa, Ida, Lampen, Erota, Boi, Chatzen. Bakant ist sehr kein Spiel auf alle Instrumenten. Hoy singt sich dabei, in der singt sich dabei. Sim, 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 zudeck, in der Walle bis zum Grunde. Hoy, wer ihr spielt,
thank you. Dick Schulman-Mentz. Pete Ruchevsky.
I'm going to sing an old-time ballad now that I know from a remarkable woman, Avishalom, the late Bronya Sakina, who came from southern Ukraine, southwestern Ukraine, the area called Podolia, which is part of the area of Jewish Eastern Europe that really was, by the time of the aforementioned Jewish ethnographic expeditions in the 1911 to 1914 was really like a kind of like the southern mountains or Appalachia in terms of its richness of Yiddish traditions, musical traditions and otherwise. And Bronya came to this country from the Soviet Union in 1980 and spent the rest of her life in Brooklyn, but she came from a small town, a small shtetl in called Olvanysk. Anyone here from Olvanysk? It's known as Holovanysk in Ukrainian, Golovanysk in Russian. And she, like many of the individuals we refer to, was just an incredible Volksmensch, as we say in Yiddish, someone who carried the whole culture within them in terms of songs, dances, virtuoso cooking in the Yiddish tradition, folk remedies, et cetera, et cetera. And
a beautiful dancer.
Right, including dance, which is subsumed normally under culture, but so this is one of her ballads. The love ballads of particularly of Jewish women, which is very much a women's tradition, which men also sing, but almost all of them revolve around the travail that resulted from the institution of what's called in Yiddish a shidduch, the arranged marriage, and all kinds of hell that broke loose as a result of that. People not being able to marry who they wanted to, parents meddling in their children's affairs. Right, not only an old story, but maybe it's... So this is a... It's a story that's kind of like a Russian novel, and I won't, it would take a long time to explain everything that happens, but the basic gist of it is it has to do with a young man and a young woman who fell in love with each other, but because of their class differences, that often is a big part of these ballads that, that's what gets in the way. Because of he was rich and she was poor, his parents wouldn't let him marry her. So years go by and he is coming as a beggar, asking for alms for people. And he's standing on the street asking for bread. And she recognizes him. He doesn't recognize her. In the meantime, she's become rich. And at the end of the song, he says, "You don't have to tell me what I've done, because I know very well that everything I did to you was my undoing, and therefore from my eyes there are rivers of tears that are running when I think of what I did to you," which is the only example in folklore we know of a man actually apologizing to a woman. So it's right.
Hold on to that.
It's sweet in that sense. Der Barmda, meine liebe Menschen,
Der paramtach hinter anoit in a god zola chmiteile min git benschen. Der paramtach in a schenktashtikl brois. Noi vaso je schemste sich nit gein a so ju gerissen. Vaso je schemste sich nit oi strecken da non. Nor du sensiki, wollt ihr gewollt wissen, fim von eti jese dein Gebäurenland. Ui ma Gebäurenland, isa chaseir wat. Hoi in gezeugen, bin ich chaseir rach, nor der keine Liebe. Bin ich verworren geworden. Hoin jetzt geh ich a beten bereit bach. Ziot ihr biot, eppes mir schenken. Tolle mich mir, wat gein. Bise wo nit ihr will, du leib mach renken. Sie hat ihr den Kanurim mohen nicht gesehen. Oh, ich hab schon lang bei Gott ausgebeten. Also fremde Tieren soll ich doch sehen. In Asia hab das nur bei Gott ausgebeten. Tot ich noch hab ich alle stehen leben mir. Oi tige noch, abis alle leben mir stehen. In Lammach und dir, sie setzen die Goll, man dienst weh dir, ane du war aus der Rogen. Sie weh dir suchen, atus sotos gut fahr mir. Ach, ihr Dien, sie darf mir gur nit zugen, weil ich weiß allein, als ich kim op farach, finne meine Augen gießen Tachen terrieren. Wenn ich der Mosach, wo sich geht in die Nacht, finne meine Augen gießen Tachen terrieren. Wenn ich der Mann sag, wo sich geht in die Nacht.
Also.
As Michael kind of alluded to towards the beginning of our set, what we're doing and what we're kind of all about in exploring this culture and this language and this music is continuing it, which means, in the case of a tradition, I think if it doesn't move forward, it dies. So a very important aspect of what we're doing is creating new songs, new melodies, new works in Yiddish in this long line of a tradition. Sometimes it sounds like old music. It sounds like it could come from the roots of this tradition, but it's new. What we're going to do now is kind of present a sort of somewhat abbreviated wedding suite. The kinds of different songs or melodies or dances that would be used at a Jewish wedding. But a lot of the melodies we're going to play are new compositions, a couple of mine, one of Michael's. Sort of following in this tradition. And Michael is going to be a badchen. You want to maybe say a couple words about a badchen?
Yeah, the traditional wedding poet, MC, jester often, although who improvises along a formula, rhymed couplets that, but in this case, traditional weddings in a lot of societies are not necessarily just the kind of flowers and smiles that we're used to with the quote American weddings.
It's June. Hmm?
And it's right. I was getting to that indeed. But yes, and though it's June, weddings are as those of you who have gotten married or have kind of witnessed people getting married, know there's a lot more to weddings than just having a good time, although that's part of it. And in traditional Jewish weddings, there's, as like in many cultures, there's the first part of the wedding, the ceremony, is very solemn often because it's a serious occasion. It's a major rite of passage, and traditionally, young people are leaving their parents' homes, or at least one of them is, and going on to a whole new life and with a certain amount of uncertainty attached to it. So what the Badchen, the traditional wedding poet, does is to improvise couplets that talk about this transition, and often bring the wedding guests to tears by saying what a momentous occasion this is. And so there's some of that worked in there too here.
I think there's some kind of saying out there that means that a good violinist can make a bride cry.
Not just a bride, right?
Or, well,
and a groom,
everyone,
too.
Yeah.
And everybody else.
So we'll see if I can do that.
Dos fara mine gas da pat khneret mit mishalem zog hi raz ayoy mazen iftakh asvorim oy shrayt im vein takal mit reir namorim
מדר זוג מנה מרדפונך מנה דבר ישב מורם שעת שעת שעת
Thank you. That's our Botkin, Michael Alpert. Our erste fiddler, our first fiddler, Jake Schulman-Ment. On vocals, the lovely Ethel Rame. I'm Pete Reshevsky. I do want to thank a couple of folks who support the Center for Traditional Music and Dance, our Onsky Institute for Jewish Culture. We get a lot of support from the Atran Foundation and the Keller Shatnoff Foundation, as well as your National Endowment for the Arts, which we should all be very proud of. So thanks so much for that support. Thanks so much to Betsy, the American Folklife Center, and the Library of Congress. We're going to do one more tune, right? And we'll feature Michael Alpert on this one.
This is a tune for leading people home from the wedding. So,
I don't want to mention one else thing. At least one of us has CDs, which I'm not allowed to say you can, but they're available if you're interested. You could find out more after the
if
show.
If you would
come
like
up
to take
stage.
This music home with you, let's say that. Come see us after.
It's late. Take me home. Take me home, but don't let anyone see us. So with that, yeah, come and see us afterwards, right? Thanks a lot for being here. And let's see each other on happy and peaceful occasions. Merci.
This has been a presentation of the Library of Congress. Visit us at loc.gov.